game day in our kitchen today, and I am making the most delicious bacon crackers with sour cream and onion dip. But the real story is the man joining me who's right beside me. He is known for rescuing bars around the country. And let me tell you something, they need some rescuing if you've seen this show. Today he is in our kitchen and he is going to be serving us his amazing mocktails. Please welcome to our home for the first time, John Taffer. Welcome, John.
Hi, great to be here, Deb.
We're very excited to have you. But I'd just like to start off by saying, are we okay here?
Well, you know, first of all, the kitchen smells too clean. That makes me uncomfortable.
Okay, there you
it's
go.
Too clean all in all. I have nothing to throw, Deb. I'm not used to this kind of an environment. I hope I can function.
It makes me feel good because you're not going to yell at us. That's
no, look at this place.
We're going to serve us delicious drinks. Larissa, Kimmy, and Maria are going to appreciate these. I know, Kimmy, you're
yes,
going to like
sure.
them.
Yes, for sure.
Because these are all natural. So you have a new line of drink mixers, and they
yes.
are organic. No sugar added.
Oh, wow.
How did you come up with this?
So, you know, after 185 bar rescues, Deb, I got to do new recipes every week.
Oh, this is mm-hmm. delicious.
And you find some that you love, no different than your work.
Right.
So I started with flavors, and the flavors were so good, then I chose to bring them to market.
Oh.
So it really started with the flavors and the ingredients. So these are sweetened with monk fruit and stevia. There's no sugar added.
I love that.
So in very many cases, the Bloody Mary mix is 15 calories. We have a skinny margarita mix that's 80 calories with the tequila.
Wow.
But what's great about it is it doesn't have the artificial preservatives in it, and you can taste the difference.
Yeah,
so good.
And it's not just, if you don't drink alcohol, that's absolutely fine because these drinks are delicious.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is alcohol free.
Yeah.
That's alcohol. Free. And there's a way to do it alcohol-free that actually adds flavor to it.
Okay. So
can I make you one?
Let's make it. You're
Please.
Making us a virgin pina colada.
So this is a virgin pina colada without alcohol. So this is the mix right out of the bottle.
Okay.
So I'm going to do about 3.5 ounces of mix now.
All right.
If I take that mix and I'm making an alcoholic drink, I would just add 1.5 ounces of alcohol and I'm done.
Okay.
Right? Shake it up and I'm ready to serve. But if we're not using alcohol, I add a little coconut cream for sweetness. And then a little bit of lime juice for sour.
Oh, my goodness.
So we're adding another flavor dynamic to compensate for the lack of alcohol.
Cameron would love this.
Oh my gosh, he would.
A quick little shake.
Look at that.
Right, you don't want to overshake it because you don't want it to get too watery.
That's right, there you go.
Oh, I would so do this.
Oh boy, okay, I got nervous there.
No, I'm not going to get you, Deb. I promise, you're clear. So now we'll pour out.
It.
Look at the thick creaminess of the cocktail.
It's beautiful. And I love how you've rimmed the glass with toasted coconut.
Yeah,
toasted coconut. You always want to dress a cocktail nicely because it just creates much more of an experience. So a beautiful straw. Look at the ribbing. Look at the beautiful color.
Cheers.
Beautiful.
Cheers.
Full side.
I love it. Now I'm going to make a delicious dip and some crackers to go along with our virgin pina colada for game day. While I do this, would you explain to everyone just how important it is when you are making an organic product to make sure it's in a glass bottle? This is really interesting information.
I
was talking to him, but you know this, Kimmy, because you're doing the same thing.
So when I created these products, it was all about freshness and great ingredients. And I learned that you can't put juices in a plastic bottle if it's unrefrigerated. And here's why. You have to hot fill. So we had to use glass bottles, had to redesign production process. A glass bottle is hot filled, so it doesn't need artificial preservatives. Then it's vacuum sealed. So when you see a product in a glass bottle, more likely than not, it doesn't have the artificial preservatives.
Isn't that wonderful? So
if you have a choice of buying a mixer in a plastic bottle or in a glass bottle, go for the glass bottle every
time. Wonderful.
And it's not only healthier, but it doesn't have that aftertaste
that
your preservatives give, right?
That's right. So I'm making our delicious dip over here. You guys please dip in.
Speaking of aftertaste, what is that?
Well, that smells great.
Thank you. So would this be okay in one of the bars?
Oh, it would be great.
Hold on, you have a cocktail or mocktail on your eyebrow. Oh. There we go. I got it for you, John. So I have added together just some goat cheese, some sour cream, caramelized onions, which are very important, chives, salt and pepper, and a little bit of Worcestershire sauce.
Wow.
And that's it.
That's amazing.
You just mix it all
really
together. Now, you want to make sure your onions are caramelized and chopped. The reason you want them caramelized is, well, number one, it brings out a sort of
sweetness.
It's just a nicer flavor profile. Mm-hmm. And for me specifically, I can't have onions that are raw.
Oh,
they really upset my stomach. And if you have a problem with your stomach, if you caramelize or grill onions, you're likely you'll be able to stomach them. So
may
to speak.
I say, if you're at a party as well, it doesn't give you bad breath.
It's not quite as offensive
it's
either.
It's not as right. offensive as rock.
Okay. But you also remove the moisture. That's right. So some of the moisture comes out, which increases the flavor profile.
That's right, and it doesn't make your dip watery.
Wow,
now, these aren't normal crackers. What have you done to
these?
These
are normal
pretty amazing.
Crackers. Right. They're pretty delicious. So these are my bacon crackers. Very simple to make as well. All I did was take a butter cracker, I wrapped it with a piece of bacon, and then I put them on a cookie sheet or a tray and put them in the oven very low at 250. And you're gonna bake these until the bacon actually crisps up. So probably about an hour or so, an hour and 15 minutes. Mm. And then you pull them out, your bacon's crispy and you're good to go.
And you're removing a lot of the fat from the bacon
That's
as well.
Right. Right.
So
well,
it's much leaner,
Are
much
you
healthier.
Learning all these things on the road on
Boy,
Bar Rescue?
I've learned so much, Deb, since I got here.
Oh,
no. Honestly, I have. So next is a mix line. You got to start creating some dips.
Thank you so much. Both of these are amazing and will definitely be put to use on
this
game
is
day.
So good.
It's so good. And you can find John's mixers at Walmart's across the country. And you can get all of these game day recipes online at HallmarkChannel.com.